Hi YouTube, this is AlsoX for 00x.com on YouTube at 00x, all one word, no spaces, and on Instagram at Quantic Films. On today's video, we'll be unboxing and setting up the Thrustmaster T300 RS GT Edition steering wheel combo. This steering wheel is compatible with PC, PlayStation 3 and PlayStation 4. The GT denomination is for Gran Turismo. It has three pedals, it has sequential shifters for the manual transmission, and you can add parts, it's modular, you can add a stick shift later, as well as change the steering wheel itself from the base. The T300 base can be equipped with different steering wheels. You have Ferrari steering wheels with Alcantara, with the wood treatment, Formula One steering wheels. This one is the GT wheel that has all the keys, all the triggers for a PlayStation 4 controller, like a DualShock 4, and you can use them as well with the PC. Now the technology that has in there are the, it has a 1080 degree rotation, it has the three pedals, which means it also has the clutch, the accelerator and the brake. It has the hard technology, that's the Thrustmaster's hard technology, basically brushless servo motors and belts. It has two belts for a more realistic feedback and resistance on the wheel. It is a GT edition, that means Gran Turismo. It's official for the Gran Turismo racing simulators on the PlayStation consoles, and it comes with the PlayStation branded, but it is also compatible with PC. It has a switch between PlayStation 3 and PlayStation 4. All you gotta do is switch it to PlayStation 3 and you can race it on the PC. It has some issues with Steam, but it runs in other services like Xboxes, gaming services fine, or in other games. It comes and goes, depends on Steam and when they have beta drivers or new releases, new updates, it will work fine. And this is the wheel itself, the wheel that comes with our kit, the GT wheel. It has all the keys for the PlayStation 4 and PlayStation 3. The main point in this with this steering wheel kit is the value. Gives it a realistic feel. It has three pedals, it has a manual transmission and value. So you get a more realistic feel for an affordable price. Some of the other Thrustmaster steering wheel kits share the base. You can get the base with only two pedals. This one has three pedals and the paddle shifters. It comes with adjustable pedals as well. You can move the pedals from left to right, and then you can change the steering wheel. The quick change mechanism is not that quick. You have, it's not the same as cars. You have to have a screwdriver available. You have to rotate the wheel. It is a process. That is a very good steering wheel, not just for starters. Let's check what else is in the box, and let's unbox and let's take the stuff out. And we'll show you next, after the close-ups, how to set it up the first time. This is the base. It's gonna help you keep the steering wheel, or the base of the steering wheel, attached to the table or your setup, your steering, your racing setup. The steering wheel. This is the actual base with the servo motors and the belts. You can see there the quick change mechanism. This is the T300 base. There's a connection in the middle. Electronic connection to transfer the data, the information from the steering wheel to the rest of the system. PlayStation 4, PlayStation 3, that two modes. And we also have the left trigger and the right trigger on the base itself. The other triggers will be on the steering wheel. It has a USB connection, It goes to the computer or PlayStation, as well as the power connection. And it has one connection without the cable right now that goes to the pedals. Here we have the manual, the starting guide, different languages. Now let's take out the pedals. Pedals, they're very heavy, very heavy duty. They're metal, they're made of metal, the pedals themselves. It has some very solid strings, which creates very good resistance as the cable that will go connected to the servo motor, to the base of the steering wheel. And they're, you can unscrew them and move them like that. Since modular, you can get different pedals as well. There's different options. Once you get the bass and the steering wheel, you can get only two pedals for automatic transmission, or at the upgrades of three pedal kits. They have different three pedal kits with different grades of quality or roughness. Like I said, more heavy duty pedals. Now, these are all the parts that we got out of the unboxing. On the left, you can see that limiter is for the pedals to limit the spring action on the pedals. That's part of the base to keep the base on the table. There's a power cable. That's also that piece of plastic, also is support, helps support the base through the table. As for the pedal, and that's the steering wheel. The quick change mechanism on the motor, on the base itself. Let's take a closer look at the pedals, metal, very nice spring action, and the steering wheel. Has the PlayStation button, of course. Okay, now when connecting the steering wheel to the base, the first time set up, you gotta rotate the cover a little bit that goes in there. There's a connection in the middle, but you gotta rotate the cover a little bit out so the steering wheel can fit in there. So the first time, move it up a little bit and then try to connect the steering wheel. It has a connection in the middle that's like a PS2 port for the data, and then you gotta screw the cover, covering the connection like this, like so, see? And it has a screw on top. Once you finish screwing the cover, then you gotta put the screw all the way to the bottom so it can hold it in place and it won't move when you move the steering wheel. It won't unscrew the cover itself. It's something you gotta remember. Otherwise, it doesn't connect fine. You have to be very careful that it has locked into place. And then you run your test with the game, with Steam, with Xbox, whatever it is you're using on PC, Xbox Game Pass, etc. There's all kinds of services, or whenever you're, whatever your service is with your racing simulator. And this is a perfect setup for a racing sim use. Then you gotta screw it once it's all connected, and then you're ready to use it. Alright, so that was OsoX with 00x.com on YouTube at 00x. Thank you for watching. Peace.